Hi, everybody. My name is Tanya Hack, and I'm the Senior Director of Programs at Games for Change.
And I'm Arana Shapiro, and I'm the Managing Director at Games for Change.
And we're going to talk to you a little bit about the Games for Change Student Challenge, a game design program and competition reaching youth throughout the United States. The Games for Change Student Challenge is a special program that combines students' passion for games with 21st century skill building and civic engagement. Why games? Kids are super passionate about games and they spend most of their time playing games anyway. By focusing students on becoming creators of games and not just consumers, we're empowering them to be more active citizens and change makers in their own community. Games are also particularly well situated to help build 21st century skills. Students are learning how to be collaborative, how to use their creativity, and how to communicate with one another. The Student Challenge includes a number of different program components, which I'm quickly going to run through. At the start of the year, we offer professional development to cohorts of teachers in each participating city. In some cities like Detroit, this may be 20 schools teachers, and in other cities like New York City, we might have 75 teachers in our cohort. Those teachers then bring the game design curriculum back into their classrooms and teach the impact game design curriculum as part of a course during the school day or as part of an after-school program. Students can also learn about how to design games through weekend game jams hosted by Games for Change and theme partners. We've also built an online community of students, parents, teachers, and games industry professionals where folks can congregate online, speak to one another about their learning experiences, and build new skills. The program culminates in the springtime with a competition which is run in each participating city and also at a national level. At the end of the competition, we celebrate students' work through an award ceremony, which are typically hosted at cultural institutions in each of the cities. This past year, for the first year, the virtual award ceremony was, of course, online. Each year, we align ourselves with theme partners at a national level. And students then introduce those themes into the games that they're designing for the program. Examples of our past theme partners have included AT&T, who supported an inclusive play accessibility theme this past year, as well as iCivics, who supported a theme that had students thinking about the entrance of a third political party into our two-party political system. In past years, we worked with National Geographic around a theme on endangered species. And the first year of the program, we worked with the ACLU on a theme around youth justice. So 5 years of impact. The Student Challenge program has now officially run for 5 years, and we're excited to say that we've had a pretty big impact. We've reached almost 30,000 students with the program through in-school game design courses, weekend game jams, and through participation in the competition. We've trained almost 400 teachers on how to teach impact game design in schools. The challenge has run in various cities, including New York City, Los Angeles, Detroit, Atlanta, Houston, Pittsburgh, and Dallas. Students have created nearly 3,000 original impact games to submit to our competition. They've also attended 50 game jams and meetups on the weekends. And lastly, it's important to recognize that our program is reaching underserved communities and that 77% of our participating schools are Title I. Partnering with the Student Challenge. We work with different types of partners for the program. We work at the local level with city partners who our local schools, cultural institutions, and an anchor partner who runs the program in a particular city. We work with theme partners at the national level who provide resources for our students online, who participate in game jams, and then participate as judges in the competition. And we work with national partners who sponsor the program and enable us to offer it for free to students, teachers, and schools. This slide shows kind of the breadth of programs or of partners that we've worked with over the years. Some of these are theme partners, some of them are national funders, and some of them are our local anchor partners. And my point here is that this program really relies on a coalition of partners to find success. And we're so grateful to have worked with all these impressive organizations and companies to help bring this program to life. I wanted to show you a few photos from this past year. In the teacher professional development photo, you can see a couple of our educators working on a prototyping activity as part of their professional development. The same activity is being worked on by teachers in New York City, Los Angeles, Atlanta, and Detroit. At our game jams, the first activity of the day also focuses on students learning how to design games, first with physical materials, before they bring those prototypes to the computer and develop them with code. And as you can see from these screenshots from our youth game design competition, students' games are built in a variety of different platforms. They include very personal art styles, and they really range a lot in terms of their format, in terms of their content, and we're always blown away by the creativity and the innovative approach to the themes that students bring to the table. At our award ceremony, we celebrate students and their work, and we often invite them up to the main stage and interview them when they're announced as winners so that they can share their experience creating games. And thanks to a generous sponsorship from Take-Two Interactive, we offer our grand prize winners a $1,000 scholarship as part of the competition. So what's next?
So I'm going to talk a little bit about what's next for the Student Challenge. We are very excited about a couple of announcements that we have to make here. The first is that, as Tanya described, we have been running this program nationally, but it's been city specific. So in order for students to participate, they need to be living in the city that in one of the cities that we run the challenge in. We're very excited to announce that we are going to officially launch the challenge next year nationally, and that will allow us to expand our reach, right? So we're creating a suite of virtual learning opportunities that will allow students across the country to be able to participate in the challenge and the competition. This is also good timing, I would say, as more learning migrates online, especially post-COVID. We are happy that we'll be able to provide these opportunities virtually and have the resources available to students, whether or not they're in a city that, whether or not their city is having in-person learning experiences or not. So some of the resources we'll be able to offer are free access to a whole suite of virtual resources that will include curriculum that we've been designing that will help students learn how to design games as well as level up into different game design platforms. We also, over the next 2 years, will be launching an online learning community, and we'll be running virtual professional developments for teachers that are outside of our city cohorts, as well as online events, workshops, game jams, and award ceremonies. So we'll be able to do most of the program virtually, so we're really excited about that, so that we'll be able to reach students from across the country and not be so city specific. The second announcement we have is that we're really excited about a new partnership that we have with Numinous Games to teach students how to design games for accessibility. So this partnership will include resources that will also be able to be distributed to our city schools and national participants that will help students learn how to design games, really thinking a lot about how to design for accessibility. We also will be launching a set of activities and mini challenges that will give students hands-on experience designing for accessibility. And we're super excited about adding a new competition category to our student challenge that is all around accessibility. So students can submit their game to be judged as the best game designed for accessibility. And we're really excited about that.
Great. So we hope that you'll get in touch with us and help us bring game design to students in your city. Our email and our website are right here. And please feel free to contact us and tell us how you can get involved. And we would love to hear from you. So thank you so much.